Hello and welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to cover a question from the book Cracking the Coding Interview, and we are going to look at a problem from the chapter Linked List. So let's look at the problem statement. The problem statement is that we have to partition a linked list around a value x. What does it mean? It means that we have been given a head of the linked list and we have been given some values in the linked list, and we have to partition around a value x. And that x can be anything, and we have to arrange a linked list in such a way that all values less than x falls in the front of the linked list and all values greater than or equal to x falls at the back of the linked list. So let's take an example. Here let's assume that our x is equal to 4. Now if we see, the original linked list is 4, 3, 1, 11, 5, 9, and 2. Now if we partition the linked list around 4, then we can see that all values which are greater than 4 are at the end of the linked list and all the values which are less than x are in the front of the linked list. So 3, 1 and 2 are less than 4, hence they are in the front. 4, 11, 5 and 9 are greater than or equal to x, hence they are in the back. So we have to design such an algorithm. So let's think of the solution. So before jumping straight into the solution, we can ask a clarifying question from the interviewer, that whether we have to preserve the order of the elements. It means that the relative order of elements should be same in the modified list. So it means that if 4 is coming after, if 4 is coming before 11, then it should also appear before 11 in the modified list. But let's assume for the sake of this question that we don't have to preserve the order. It means that 3, 1, 2 can be in any order. Similarly, 4, 11, 5, 9 can be in any order. The only constraint is that all the elements less than x should be before, then all the elements less than, greater than or equal to x. That means the possible solution can also be 1, 2, 3, 11, 4, 5, 9, where this defines a partition that all the elements greater than x lies here and all the elements less than x lies here. So now let's look at various possible solutions of it. So let's look at the four pointer solution. So we have been given the head of the original linked list, and we can prepare two linked lists such that first linked list contains all elements less than x and the second linked list contains all elements greater than or equal to x. So whenever we encounter any element which is less than x, we'll append at the end of the first linked list, and if we get any element greater than or equal to x, we will append that element at the end of the second linked list. So let's begin to iterate the original linked list. Now the head of the original linked list points here. So when we iterate, we see that 4 is greater than equal to x, because x is equal to 4, hence it will be appended to the second linked list. Now the start of the second linked list is empty, hence we initialize second linked list start and second linked list end with this pointer, and its next would be null. Now the rest of the linked list remains same, and the first linked list is still null. Now we move the pointer here. Now 3 is less than x, hence it will be appended to the first linked list. Now if we come here, the second linked list remains the same. The first linked list start and first linked list end points here, and its next points to null, and the rest of the linked list remains same. Now when we come to 1, it is also less than x, hence it gets appended to the end of the first linked list. So now the start of the first linked list points here and end of the first linked list points here, and the second linked list start and end remains the same, and the rest of the linked list remains same. Now when we move to 11, it is greater than x, hence it gets appended to the end of the second linked list. So here the start of the second linked list is here and end of the second linked list moves, and the first linked list remains same, and similarly the rest of the linked list remains same. Now when we move to 5, it also gets appended to the end of the second linked list. Hence second end moves and second start remains same, and this also remains same. Now when we come to 9, it gets appended at the end of the second linked list. When we come to 2, it gets appended at the end of the second, at the end of the first linked list. So you can see now that we have two linked lists where all the elements greater than equal to x lies in the second linked list, and all the elements less than x lies in the first linked list. Now we can point the end of the first linked list to the start of the second linked list such that we get the final list. So we move these two pointers to 4 such that we get one linked list. Now if we see the time complexity of this solution, it is order of n, where n is the number of elements in the linked list, because we are iterating the linked list only once and we are just modifying a few pointers. So that is all about the solution. Now if you notice, we assumed one thing at the start of the question, that the order of the elements do not matter, that is the relative order of the elements do not matter, and one possible solution can be 1, 2, 3, 11, 4, 5, 9, because this just partitions the element as less than x and greater than x, but it is not necessary that 3 should always come before 1. Here any order can be there. So can we think of a more concise solution? May not be the optimal solution, but a better solution which might not preserve the order but can be concisely written. So let's see that solution. So let's see a concise solution using two pointers. Here we'll iterate the linked list and we'll create a new linked list, only one linked list, such that whenever we encounter any element less than the x, we will append at the head of the linked list, and if we get any element greater than or equal to x, we will append at the end of the linked list. So let's see. Here the head of the linked list points here, and let's assume that we have two pointers, start and end. Now this 4 is the first element and it is greater than equal to x, hence our start and end points here. Now when we come to 3, 3 is less than x, hence it will get appended at the head of the linked list, which is here, and we'll move the start and the end remains here. Now we get 1, again it is less than x, hence it appends at the end of, at the start of the linked list, and the end remains same. Now when we move to 11, it is greater than x, hence it appends at the end of the linked list and the start remains same. Now when we come to 5, again it gets appended at the end because it is greater than x and start remains same. Now when we append 9, it appends at the end of the linked list and 2 at the start of the linked list. So here you see the final solution, the relative order of the original linked list is not maintained, because here 2 is coming after 1, but here 2 is coming before 1, hence the relative order is changing. Also the time complexity of this solution is also order of n, because we are iterating the original linked list once, where n is the number of elements in the linked list, and we are just changing the pointers. So I hope you have understood the two different solutions and the constraints and the trade-offs of each solution. So whenever you are designing a solution, please discuss all these solutions and their trade-offs with the interviewer, with the put-up constraints. So I hope you have liked this video and understood how the partition of a linked list will work and what are various solutions to it. I have attached the code of the GitHub repository in the description section below. Please feel free to provide your inputs or suggestions in the comment section. Thank you.